Welcome to Roving Camera. I'm Rashika Gangwani, bringing you the highlights of the events that took place in the Parliament last week. On the occasion of Indian Armed Forces Flag Day, officers of Kendra Senic Board pinned flag on Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla at his office. This day is observed every year on December 7 since 1949. To honour the soldiers, airmen and sailors of India who fought on the borders to safeguard the country's honour.
Officers of Kendri Sainik Board on Tuesday pinned a flag on Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla on the occasion of the Armed Forces Flag Day. Armed Forces Flag Day is dedicated towards collection of funds from people of India for the welfare of Indian Armed Forces personnel. It has been observed annually in India on December 7 since 1949. Over the years, it has become a tradition to commemorate this day as an honour to the soldier, sailor and airman of India. The Armed Forces Flag Day Fund has been constituted by the Government of India for the welfare and rehabilitation of the ex-servicemen community. Armed Forces Flag Day Fund was set up in 1993 to extend support to disabled ex-servicemen, war widows, children of martyrs and other such beneficiaries who need our care and support.
On December 4, Chairman Rajya Sabha M. Venkaiah Naidu met leader of Cameroon Parliament delegation in his chamber at the Parliament House.
A parliamentary delegation from Cameroon, headed by Nijungum Musa Mabuto, leader of delegation, called on the Vice President of India and Chairman Rajya Sabha M. Venkaiah Naidu in Parliament House. Welcoming the delegation, Naidu stated that both India and Cameroon enjoy close and friendly ties which have steadily progressed over the years. Recognizing the importance of Africa and in particular Cameroon, India recently decided to establish a resident mission in Cameroon which has been established on 12th of September 2019. Mr. Naidu expressed the hope that with the establishment of the mission in Cameroon, the relationship between the two countries would be further strengthened. The delegation led by Mr. Nijungum Musa Mabuto appreciated the friendly relationship between the two countries and hoped that such visit would further strengthen the existing bonds.
The nation paid homage to Bharat Ratna Baba Saheb Dr. B.R. Ambedkar on his 64th Mahaparinirvan Divas on December 6th. The President, Vice President, Prime Minister, Lok Sabha Speaker and other dignitaries offered tribute to the father of the Indian Constitution, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, at the Sansad Bhavan lawns in the Parliament House complex.
The nation remembered the architect of Indian Constitution and Bharat Ratna Dr. B.R. Ambedkar on his 64th death anniversary. Dr. Ambedkar died on 6th of December 1956. Since then, Mahaparinirvan Divas is observed every year to pay him tributes. Dr. Ambedkar is remembered for his triumphant struggle against age-old social discrimination against Dalits, women and labour classes. President Ramnath Kovind led the nation in paying homage to Bharat Ratna Baba Saheb Dr. B.R. Ambedkar on his 64th Mahaparinirvan Divas. The President offered floral tributes at the statue of Baba Saheb at Sansad Bhavan lawns in Parliament House complex. Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu, Prime Minister Narendra Modi, Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla, former Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh, Social Justice and Empowerment Minister Thawar Chand Gehlot, Parliamentary Affairs Minister Prahlad Joshi and members of Parliament also offered tributes to the father of the Indian Constitution, Dr. Ambedkar. The function was organized by the Ambedkar Foundation, an autonomous organization under the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment.
मैं आज के इस दिन में अंबेडकर साहब के चरणों में विनम्र श्रद्धांजलि अर्पित करता हूं और भारतवासियों से निवेदन करता हूं कि भारत का संविधान बनाने में अंबेडकर साहब की अहम भूमिका रही है। आज भी वे संविधान प्रासंगिक है। हम संविधान के अनुसार काम करके देश को आगे बढ़ाने का प्रयास करें।
On December 5th, Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla attended the 71st Annual Conference of the Cardiological Society of India at Ashoka Hotel in New Delhi.
Every year, Cardiological Society of India organizes annual conference to share as well as spread knowledge and wisdom among all its stakeholders. The 71st Annual Conference is aimed at encouraging active participation, particularly from the young and budding cardiologists. In addition, this conference put forth a coordinated, combined and collaborative effort from cardiologists spread across the globe to disseminate knowledge as well as know-how of new treatments, besides leveraging technology for the benefit of the participants. Thus, it will be an effective forum for participants to exchange ideas, inventions, innovations, build efficient and effective networks and initiate new collaborations. Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla addressed the gathering of the Cardiological Society of India. Birla said that since its inception, Cardiological Society of India is doing commendable work along with various institutions towards the treatment of heart problems. He also said, CSI efforts are playing an important role in providing excellent treatment. Birla said, busy lifestyle and work pressure have an impact on the mind, brain and heart. Cardiovascular diseases are a matter of serious concern at an early age. He hoped that this forum would work towards solving problems by combining the experiences of people working on cardiovascular diseases.
इतनी चिकित्सा व्यवस्था होने के बाद भी हृदय रोग से मृत्यु का आंकड़ा लगातार बढ़ना एक चिंताजनक भी है और इसकी चिंता आप कर रहे हैं। मुझे खुशी होती है जब चिकित्सकगण किस तरीके से बेहतरीन चिकित्सा के साथ साथ सामाजिक रूप से भी अपने ज्ञान अनुभव के आधार पर भी किस तरीके से एक व्यक्ति लंबी उम्र पाए उसके लिए समय समय पर आप सोसाइटी को जागृत भी करते रहते हैं। आपका ज्ञान अनुभव से सोसाइटी को अपने पेशे के बाद भी मार्गदर्शन करने का काम करते हैं। हृदय रोग होने का जो मूल कारण आप ज्यादा जानते हैं, लेकिन अपनी खान पान, अपनी दिनचर्या, इसको किस तरीके से निमित किया जा सकता है और हृदय रोग होने के कारण वह अगर जानकारी हमारे सभी सांसदों को हो और वह सांसद प्रयास करे कि अपने क्षेत्र की आपकी दी जानकारी को किस तरीके से समाज तक पहुंचाने का काम करें, इसलिए हमारी जिम्मेदारी ज्यादा बन जाती है। लेकिन फिर भी मुझे खुशी है कि जो काम हमको करना चाहिए, जो जिम्मेदारी हमारी है, वो जिम्मेदारी आप निभाते हैं। आप समाज के लिए, देश के लिए जिस समर्पित सेवा भाव से काम कर रहे हैं, एक तरफ हृदय लोगों के चिकित्सक के माध्यम से उसको स्वस्थ बनाने का प्रयास कर रहे हैं, वहाँ हृदय रोग न हो इसके लिए आप उनको उनकी जीवन की दिनचर्या और होने के कारण बताकर हृदय रोग को कम करने का जो आपका प्रयास है वो निश्चित रूप से आपका सराहनीय है।
लोकसभा स्पीकर ओम बिरला मेट स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ माइंड ट्री स्कूल फ्रॉम अंबाला डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ पंजाब इन द पार्लियामेंट हाउस कॉम्प्लेक्स।
A group comprising 4 teachers and 45 students from Mind Tree School from Ambala district of Punjab visited Parliament House at Delhi on 5th of December. As part of their education trip, the group met Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla in the Parliament House complex. Interacting with the school children, Lok Sabha Speaker said, "Childhood memories become alive by meeting children." He said that this type of study visits are appreciated in increasing understanding and knowledge of parliamentary traditions and procedure in future generations of the country.
A group of parliamentary delegation from Maldives led by Mohammad Nasheed, Speaker of the People's Majlis of Maldives, visited the Parliament Museum.
On 9th of December, a group of parliamentary delegation from Maldives visited Parliament Museum. Parliament Museum is an interactive storytelling museum on democratic heritage in India spanning 2,500 years of Indian history of democracy. The story is woven with the help of walkthrough period settings with sound, light, video animation. Large screen, interceptive computer multimedia, immersive visualization, and multi-screen panoramic projection. Virtual reality and animatronics. The museum is developed in 6 major areas. Located in the Parliament Library Building in New Delhi, the museum was inaugurated on 14th of August 2006.
On 9th of December, Speaker of the People's Majlis of Maldives, Mohammad Nasheed, called on the Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla in the Parliament House Annexe Extension Building.
Mohammad Nasheed, Speaker of the People's Majlis of Maldives, accompanied by a 10-member delegation, visited India from December 9th to 13th as a government guest. During the visit, Speaker of Maldives called on Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla. Both the leaders discussed to focus on a range of multilateral and regional issues as well as to explore ways to strengthen India's growing engagement with the Maldives. Om Birla acknowledged the role of Mr. Nasheed in establishing democracy in Maldives and said that the developmental cooperation between India and Maldives is a symbol of friendship and mutual trust and strengthens the bilateral relations. Mr. Birla further observed that India is pleased to share its rich parliamentary experience with Maldives. He remarked that there needs to be more and more avenues of capacity building and training between the Parliament of India and the People's Majlis of Maldives. Mr. Nasheed, in his observation, recalled the deep bonds between the two countries, emphasizing that the bilateral trade needs an impetus. He hoped that India would play a purposive role in rectifying anomalies emerging out of the country's economic engagement with other countries. Later, Om Birla and Nasheed signed a memorandum of understanding on enhancing cooperation between the two parliaments. The Speaker of the People's Majlis of Maldives also signed the Golden Book.
On 9th of December, a parliamentary delegation from Maldives, led by His Excellency Mr. Mohammad Nasheed, Speaker of People's Majlis of Maldives, called on the Vice President of India and Chairman Rajya Sabha M. Venkaiah Naidu in the Parliament House Annexe Extension Building.
Welcoming the delegation, M. Venkaiah Naidu appreciated the important role Mohammad Nasheed played in ushering democracy in Maldives, as well as in promoting bilateral ties with India. Speaking on bilateral relations between the two countries, Mr. Naidu said that being a close neighbor with ties of kinship, history and culture, India shares close bonds with Maldives, and it is because of a shared democratic values, multifaceted partnership between the two countries will get consolidated. Speaking on parliamentary cooperation between the two countries, he said that as close neighbors and friends, India is happy to share its best practices in the area of parliamentary work and legislation and to strengthen institutional linkages between the Indian Parliament and the People's Majlis through training and capacity building. The delegation led by Mr. Mohammad Nasheed appreciated the friendly relationship between the two countries and hoped that such visit would further strengthen the existing bonds.
Parliamentarians paid floral tributes to see Rajagopalachari on his birth anniversary in the Central Hall of the Parliament House. Rajagopalachari was the last Governor General of India, as India soon became a republic in 1950.
Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla, Leader of Opposition Ghulam Nabi Azad and former Deputy Prime Minister L.K. Advani paid floral tributes at the portrait of C. Rajagopalachari in the Central Hall of Parliament House on his birth anniversary. Among others who paid tributes to Sri Rajagopalachari were several members of Parliament, former members of Parliament and Secretary General of Lok Sabha, Snehlata Srivastava, also paid tribute to C. Rajagopalachari. It may be recalled that in recognition of the services rendered by C. Rajagopalachari to the nation, his portrait was unveiled in the Central Hall of Parliament House on 21st of August 1978 by the then President of India, Dr. N. Sanjeeva Reddy. On the occasion, Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla inaugurated an exhibition of books on C. Rajagopalachari in the Central Hall.
Chairman Standing Committee on External Affairs P.P. Chaudhary met the parliamentary delegation from Maldives led by Mohammad Nasheed, Speaker of the People's Majlis of Maldives at the Parliament House, Annex the Extension Building. With that, we have come to the end of this edition of Roving Camera. Join me next week for all the news in and around the Parliament. Keep watching Lok Sabha Television.